there, Parker Reed here, and welcome to PR Media, your home for everything movies and music through my eyes. And today we're going to be talking about the fourth studio record by country rock superstar Chris Stapleton, Starting Over. To start things off, I'm not the biggest fan of country music. Sure, I played in a country rock band for about 6 months last year, and I have appreciation for artists like Willie Nelson, Johnny Cash, Dolly Parton, the more traditional types of country artists from like the 60s, 70s, and 80s. But modern country music like Luke Bryan, that sort of thing, the stadium country music, I'm not a big fan of that. It's pretty much just like dumbed down country music to please the masses. It's not my thing, but Chris Stapleton does not fit that mold whatsoever. His debut album, Traveler, which came out about 4 or 5 years ago, it's an absolute standout in the country genre, and his two other albums From A Room Volume 1 and Volume 2, they're okay. I didn't listen to them that much as I did Traveler, but when this new album came out, I was itching for some great traditional country music, and holy crap did I find it here. Chris Stapleton is one of the most honest and hard-hitting vocalists in all of country music. You can really tell that he just wants to pick up his acoustic guitar and write a really true and honest song, and that really is portrayed on this album Starting Over. Starting Over is 14 tracks coming in at 54 minutes in length, and the entire 14-track tracklist is filled with Morgan Stapleton's background vocals. That's, of course, Chris Stapleton's wife and singing partner, and having her beautiful background vocals on a lot of these songs just kind of cleverly placed in the background really gave these songs a lot of life. This album begins with a gentler song, the titled track Starting Over, and it's one that Chris Stapleton and his wife performed solo acoustically recently at an award show, and this is one of the standout tracks on the album. It's a beautiful ode to starting over, starting a new life, and in the year 2020, that's a really attractive notion to a lot of people, and so the fact that this album is just purely about starting over, turning the page, it's even represented on the cover art, which is literally just a white record with like a little stamp at the top saying Starting Over by Chris Stapleton. It's minimalist and it's beautiful. The acoustic guitar tone on this entire record is absolutely flawless. I'm sure he has access to the greatest acoustic guitars in the world, so I'm not surprised by how great they sound, but on this opening track you really get a feel for what this album is going to throw at you. There's some beautiful piano in this song, and there's some beautiful harmonies in this track with Morgan and Chris on the chorus, and overall it's a great way to start this record, and it really got me excited for an album that I wasn't super anticipating. Starting Over is filled with some great electric guitar sounds, some really twangy Fender Telecaster-esque guitar sounds, and on songs like Devil Always Made Me Think Twice, Arkansas, Hillbilly Blood, all songs about being a country boy and loving it, that Telecaster really comes through. It hits hard, and it really gives a great aesthetic for what Chris Stapleton is going for on this album, which is a traditional country record free from a lot of the woes of a lot of stadium country music on country radio nowadays, so I love seeing that. And as far as song topics, he really runs the gamut as far as what he's talking about on this record. Songs like Cold are about lost romances and hardships in that area, and a lot of times with new records they're trying to whittle songs down to that about that 3.5 minute mark so they can get on radio, but this over 5 minute track features a great outro guitar solo and really allows the song to breathe and allows the emotion to fill throughout it and kind of climax at the end. So I loved a lot of those song structures on this record, and Chris Stapleton's voice really comes through on the more sentimental tracks like When I'm With You, Joy of My Life, and Old Friends, which are all about romance and great friends and just really appreciating the sentimental parts of your life. What a lot of macho artists wouldn't want to talk about those things. They wouldn't want to talk about how much they love their wife or how much they love all their old friends that money can't buy. And it only shows the honest and earnest period he is in his life, because he's in his 40s now. He's got a bunch of kids. He lives on a farm. So he's just reflecting on his life right now on this record. And it shows that he's wearing his emotions on his sleeve on this album. But one of my favorite songs on Chris Stapleton's Starting Over is a song called Maggie's Song, and this song isn't about a woman or a past girlfriend or his wife or anything. It's about their dog who passed away from old age, and in the song he's talking about how they found the dog, how they adopted it. It talks about Maggie playing with the kids on their farm and inevitably him passing away in Chris Stapleton's arms with his head in his hands, and that's absolutely devastating emotionally, but it's portrayed in an almost melancholy way on this song, and it really shows the connection that someone can have with their pet and how beautiful that relationship is. I mean, not every relationship explored has to be strictly romantic, person to person, or just friend to friend. It can be through different species like dogs and humans. That relationship is just as beautiful as the human to human relationships. And when I see a 14 song track list, I'm usually nervous because I'm like, oh my gosh, the front half is going to be loaded with all the potential hits, and then eventually it's going to trail off. But Chris Stapleton's Starting Over does not trail off whatsoever. The third to last song, Watch You Burn, is all about people who commit acts of violence. It talks a lot about mass shootings and how those people are going to get their comeuppance in the next life. And the wailing, twangy electric guitars in this song really hit home. Moment, along with Chris Stapleton's super powerful voice. And the last two songs being You Should Probably Leave and Nashville, Tennessee are a beautiful way to send off this record. You Should Probably Leave is probably the most pro-responsibility in relationships song. It's talking about how they don't want to make mistakes and how they should probably leave before they do something that they regret. And the song Nashville, Tennessee is literally a goodbye to the city of Nashville, Tennessee. And it shows Chris Stapleton's maturity and his reflecting on his past life in Nashville as he moved away. So that song is a great fitting goodbye for the rest of this record. So what would I rate Chris Stapleton's Starting Over? This is one of my favorite records of the year, and I really think this is a country music masterpiece. I enjoy this one a lot, and I really think you will too. It's not just for country fans, it's for anyone who's a fan of just music in general. And this is going to be a higher rating than I thought I was going to go, but I'm going to give it a 10 out of 10 for Chris Stapleton's Starting Over. It's one of my favorites of the year. It's one of the best country music albums I've ever heard, especially in modern times. So make sure you check out Chris Stapleton's Starting Over, a modern country rock masterpiece. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you like what you saw here, you can check us out on Facebook or Instagram and like, comment, and subscribe if so choose. My name is Parker Reed. You've been watching PR Media. Keep supporting physical media, and I'll see you next time. Thanks, guys. It don't matter to me. Yeah, Benny.